It's nothing creepy.
Please state your name for the folks at home when I tap you on the shoulder.
Kate.
Amber.
Kate, Amber, what do you do for a living?
Nothing.
That would explain why you're on Twitter all day begging to be on the Tootsie Fruits show all day.
Absolutely.
All day. I was trying to look up my tweets to see what was going on in the tweet land thing, and all day you've been asked to be on the show. Why?
I'm a big fan of the show. Honestly, I didn't think it would work. I really didn't think this through. I'm kind of ashamed of myself now.
But not thinking things through tells me you're just the kind of person we need here. You're gonna fit right in. What are you girls? Where are you girls from?
Originally Detroit, Michigan.
I've been there.
Yeah. I'm still from there.
Okay. It's true. It's true.
Well, where are you from now?
I live in New Orleans.
Okay. That's nice.
Yeah.
Okay. How is it? Is it all right?
I love it. Yeah.
No. I meant after the thing, you know, the storm, the big storm. Is everything okay?
Everything's okay, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Everybody's
great.
Got power back. It's awesome.
Yeah, well, take that, news. So, what do you do down there? Apart from tweeting me all day?
Nothing so far.
Okay.
Do you have
any ambitions? Something you'd like to do?
Yeah, I want to be a writer.
Ah, writer, eh?
Yeah.
What, in television?
Yeah.
You're already too good. Same for you?
No.
What do you want to do?
I like what I do right now, which is I just hang around with Chinese college students.
Hey, well, I guess somebody's got to do it. That's a job?
Yes.
Right. What do you call that job?
It's a nonprofit.
I can imagine, yeah. Okay, can't imagine. Where's the big money? Oh, well.
We show them Michigan.
Oh, mm-hmm. Well, that's great. It's nice, Michigan. I've always enjoyed it.
I like it too.
Well, so much you moved to New Orleans.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, now you've been on the show. Has it been demystified for you?
It's been wonderful. Thank
Good.
You.
Let me just excuse me just a second. Because I put them on the show for annoying me on Twitter, that doesn't mean that I'm ever going to do it ever again for anyone else. It's hard to stay up, it's been a long, long day, and you've got the Sandman at the door. But hang on, leave the TV on, and let's do it anyway. It's okay, you can always sleep through work tomorrow. Okay, hey, hey, tomorrow's just your future.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Denny's. America's diner is always open. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Think you're faking it. Faking it because you're afraid of the warm-up comedian. And when I say comedian, what was I talking about? Oh, yes. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, indeed.
It is. Because, of course, it's Friday. Ooh, yes, my braces say it's Friday. I call them braces. People in America, we call them suspenders, but where I grew up, we called them braces. And suspenders were things ladies wore underneath their clothes. I'm wearing those too. It was a very shaky day here in LA. It was an earthquake last night in Beverly Hills. The second one this week. Two earthquakes in a week. We didn't even have time to pick up all the broken pieces of Cher from the last one. It's terrible because people in Beverly Hills don't have any stuff to fix the holes and cracks in their houses. They've used all on their faces.
Oh no, an earthquake. You can't tell, but I'm very frightened.
And as people in Beverly Hills were running out of their homes, everyone yelled the same thing, Oscar and Emmy winners out first! Back in the rubble, Golden Globe winners! Not the only shake-up in show business, there's big shake-ups in my... See, that was like a real TV show there, right? Like it was a shake-up here and a shake-up... What'd they call that, a segue?
Yeah.
Masterful. Thanks, buddy. Oh, yeah, there was a big shake-up on my favorite TV show, American Idol, which I've never seen, but I love it. There's a... There's still a vacant judge's seat, and the rumors are the new judge will be Enrique Iglesias. There's a sort of, that might work from the studio audience. Yeah, that might work. The producers are in a great hurry to fill the empty seat before Clint Eastwood shows up and starts yelling at it. Now... There is a... Gosh, I thought things were going so well, and then I just suddenly looked over at a guy over there who went... Jerk. Anyway, the trailer for the new Twilight movie was released on the internet today. It's fantastic. Everyone's talking about how creepy it is. Bella turns into a vampire. Oh, sorry. Spoiler alert. She does, she turns into a vampire. I was like, what? It's very scary. We've got a picture of the vampire Bella turns into. You got it? There, look at that. The most terrifying vampire of all, Bob Barker. Have your pets spayed or neutered? Come on down. This week was the 40th anniversary of The Price is Right. The big TV special was on Tuesday, and Bob says he wasn't asked to be part of it. I know! What the hell? Apparently, The Price is Right said to its fans, come on down, but not you, Bob Barker. You stay up there. And Bob's like, why? Why can't I come on down? Now, Bob's having a war of words with the producers, and you don't want to get into a war with Barker. He's old school. He'll go plinko on your ass. He's really upset. His exact words were, they chose to ignore me. They haven't even offered me a DVD. That's true, as we said. Now, I heard that. I was shocked. I'm like, Bob Barker knows how to use a DVD player? I'm kidding, he's a broadcasting legend. Not inviting Bob Barker to a Price is Right TV special is like not inviting Tom Selleck to a moustache convention. It's like, Jeff, you got one?
It's like not inviting Dr. Phil to a convention of fake doctors.
Okay, not bad, yeah. It's like... it's like not inviting Bill Clinton to a grand opening of Hooters. I'm a vegan, but I still love breast meat. Oh yeah, Bob Barker. Bob Barker had donated millions of dollars to animal rights causes. When he goes for a walk down the street, animals flock around him like he's Snow White. Little birds perch on him. He's like, tweet, 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 tweet. When he hosted The Price is Right, he convinced the producers to stop giving away fur coats and leather goods, but times have changed. I saw the show yesterday. The showcase winner received a pair of shoes made of baby seals. I know. baby steals that were still alive. Luckily, they were size 10s, but still alive. They just put laces and heels on them and off you go. It's a joke, man. Lighten up. I'm not advocating really putting live baby seals in your feet. What the hell's wrong with you? Anyway, Drew Carey said he feels really bad about the whole thing. And Drew's been hosting The Price is Right for 5 years now, doing a great job. And it's tough taking over a show after someone else has been doing it. Trust me, I know. And it's incredibly tough if the previous host was a beloved figure adored by everyone. I'm guessing on that one, but I'm telling you, it must be. Please, don't. It's a joke. I'm a fan of... My problem here is I'm a fan and really a friend of both Drew and Bob. Although I do wonder who'd win in a fist fight. Because, like, you know, Bob's 88 years old. And Drew was a Marine. But Bob was a fighter pilot. And he's always, you know, heavily armed. He keeps a large revolver in his pocket. And a gun. Give me a picture of Drew. See, there's Drew there. Now... I've known Drew for a long time, but I will be honest, I felt more comfortable when he was heavy. The thin Drew, I'm kind of like, hey, man, what's up? When he first started hosting, he was still really big. You got a picture of Drew from back then? Yeah, there, yeah, yeah, yeah. But I think things are changing at The Price is Right, because they're breaking tradition. You can now vote online for their new spokes medal, who's going to be a dude. A male spokesmodel on The Price is Right. What's next? Bob Barker's gonna start reattaching dogs' balls? What's it gonna happen? What the hell?
Oh, I'm excited about it.
About what?
They're having a dude on the show.
Do you watch The Price is Right? Oh, you must have been on it, of course, at some point.
Oh, yeah. I was a contestant. I came on down.
Did you go on down? What happened when you went on down?
I signed a contract, I can't say.
What hand did you sign the contract with? There you go. That's the only time I've ever been able to ask you anything about your hand.
Well, feel free to ask me anything about my hand.
All right, then. Which hand do you use to write with? Which hand do you use for picking things off your body? Which hand do you use for picking things off other people's bodies? This is a really stupid show, isn't it? Hey, you wanna look at secretary?
Oh yeah.
All right. Let's look at secretary. No, stop. Now, you've ruined the moment there. We looked at Secretariat, the music didn't start, so no one was afraid.
Secretariat was late for his cue.
Yeah. You know what happens now? Nah, it's too late. Now you're gonna have to play the scary music while looking at me, because this is what Secretariat's thinking. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Everybody, I was so distracted by the Tweety Girls at the start of the show, I feel that I have paid absolutely no attention to Lesbian Row this evening, which is spectacular. What do you think, Jeff?
Some beautiful lesbians.
Beautiful, beautiful ladies of the lesbian persuasion. Lovely to see you, ladies. Thanks for coming out in all ways.
You do have a way with words.
Unfortunately, I don't have a way with lesbians, but that's because I'm not what they're after.
Oh, you'd be surprised.
I think so with the lesbians.
Well, you've often been mistaken for Liza Minnelli.
I have, that's true. But you can't let things go too far, because at a certain point it becomes obvious that I'm not. Surprise! I don't know why, I just noticed these apples were there. What time is it, Jeffrey Pierce?
It's Tweet Mail time. Tonight's Tweet Mail is brought to you by Bob Barker's Seal Shoes. Choose blubber, not rubber.
Want to play a jingle? Play a jingle. Go on.
Twitter. Twitter. Tweeting. Tweeting. Ephemeral. Ephemeral. Fleeting. Fleeting. Flugendweb. Face code. Twizzle. Asthma. Jigs a tweets. Jigs a tweets. Jigs a tweets. Jigs a tweets.
Und also E-Mails.
Und E-Mails. E-Mail time again. This is from Jordana in Green Bay, Wisconsin. You ever been to Green
Love
Bay?
It
you
Wisconsin.
Like
that?
You got a cheese head set up in the big triangular cheese head. They march up and down.
You wear it on your head.
Yeah. Why did they like cheese so much in Wisconsin?
I'm not sure. It's do they make cheese there?
Yeah, yeah, they do. Right? They just big, giant, triangular cheese hats.
That's all they make, are hats made of cheese.
Yeah, hats made of cheese. Famous for it. That's why they're so darsh garn good at football.
What the hell?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm letting it go, man. I've let it go. It's gone. I've lost it.
Well, life is a cabaret, old chum.
One of them keeps falling over. And so do the apples. Anyway, Jordana in Green Bay says, "Dear Craig and Jeff, is there anything going on right now behind that big curtain?" I don't know. Open it then, and we'll have a look. Oh, Secretary Art is there. Wait. Come on. Wait. That's not worthy of a round of applause. All right. Thanks. What are you doing, Secretariat? What is Secretariat doing behind the curtain?
The price is right. You get a new car. We've got an overzealous horse. What the hell is going on
here? It looks like the horse is either going twosies or... or... practicing. Why is the horse when a horse kneels, does that mean it's going to rain?
I think it means the horse is going to die.
Well, close the curtain then. I don't want to see that. It's unpleasant. All right. That's years. You know what that is? That is years of conditioning. When people see a curtain closing or opening and they hear music, they go, oh. But there's no reason to do it.
Got a very Pavlovian audience.
Yeah, we have, yeah. We've done one email. We have 11 seconds left, and we got 17 left to do.
Let's do it. Speed round.
Speed round, you got it. All right. This is from Blake in Canada, who says, "Dear Craig, hey, mate, could you give a shout-out to the Western Bulldogs and get their fans behind them? We need members." Western Bulldogs! This is from Jackie in Brooklyn in New York, who says, "Dear Craig and Jeff, do you recycle?" Yes. This is from Beverly in Columbus, Ohio. You ever been to Columbus, Ohio?
Yeah, sure. Love it.
Like
yeah, why not? Yeah.
Dear Craig and GP, I have to read a modern classic for one of my lit classes, and I have to choose one from the 80s onward. Any suggestions?
Hang around with Chinese students.
I don't know that that's a book, but it might be. And finally, this is from Val in Mesa, Arizona, who says, "Dear Craig and Jeff, I'm heading to the fridge at emails and tweets time. Should I go for yogurt or cheese?" Hell?
Get yourself a cheese hat, man.
Yeah, get a cheese hat.
What the hell?
Cheese hat sounds like a sex thing.
Oh, Oh, I'm sure it is.
Yeah. It will be now. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Take that, Al-Qaeda. That's why you'll never win. We have horses and chicks. I'm trying a new thing. My first guest tonight is a fantastic actor. He stars in The Big Bang Theory, which new season premieres on September 27th on CBS. Take a look at this. Kunal Nayyar, everybody, Kunal Nayyar. Kunal Nayyar. Kunal.
Ladies, please.
What do you mean, ladies? How do you know it's ladies clapping? I think the ladies weren't clapping. It was only the gentlemen that were clapping. The ladies were like, we don't care for him, Craig.
That's not true. A lady's clap is very delicate, and this was delicate clapping.
Yeah. You can tell the difference between male and female clapping?
You can't?
I can't.
Okay, close your eyes. Someone clap.
All right.
A man or a woman clap. Just one person.
All right.
No, just one person. Just, no, please, one person. Okay, one person, now.
I can tell.
Woman or man?
A man, I opened my eyes. Oh. It was a warm eye. This is a stupid game. How are you?
I was really enjoying that game, but...
That's a terrible game. It's rubbish.
I'm lovely.
You are lovely. You look great. You look very well and
really?
Fit. Yeah.
Yeah, I recently got married.
Well, so, there you are. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. So my wife dressed me today. I think that's really why I'm looking
good. Actually dressed you? Like,
she,
you stand by the side of the bed,
me.
She puts,
yeah,
your underpants
dressed.
On, yeah. And straight
no
your tie?
Just straight to the pants. It's my new thing.
You don't wear underpants?
It's my new thing, but I can't talk about it on air.
No, I think we have to.
Well, it's very freeing.
So underneath your...
Can I be honest, though? You know what it really is?
What?
Is that as I've gotten older, when I wear tight undies, it pushes the skin of my belly up, and it looks like I have a belly, which I don't really have a belly.
Whoa. If you don't have a belly, then how can it be pushed up by the underpants?
I have a little belly, that's the truth.
Well, that's part of being married. You'll get a little fatter.
Really?
Yes.
You're married, you look wonderful.
Yeah, but I'm fatter than I used to be.
That's true, you are.
Yeah. They start feeding you up in case you get any ideas.
You look... Wait, let me process that.
Yeah. In case you start thinking, I still got it going on. No, you don't have it going on.
That's the funny thing about marriage is... I'm clearly not wearing the pants in the relationship. I can't say pants without thinking about underwear. But basically, you know, my wife obviously knows me well enough to know that I'm not the most manly man in the world.
Oh, I mean, come on.
Listen, I'm not like effeminate, but I'm also not manly. But yet she still makes me do all of the manly things in the house.
Well, you have to take out the trash and all that?
Yep.
Oh, that's outrageous. Haven't we moved on? Haven't we moved on?
No, as much as progress we've made in this world, I still have to take out the trash.
What about putting up shelving? Do you have to do any of that?
I have hung a few pictures on the wall. with a hammer and a nail, which is pretty cool.
That's pretty cool.
But they're always crooked. They're always crooked because I never use that, you know, that bubble thing, the level thing, and I don't know how to use
it. No, you don't use the bubble thing. You can't do that.
What do you use?
You use a little bit of bubble gum behind, and then you get the picture right, and then you put the gum behind it, and you squeeze it in, and then it stays where you want it to go. I should have my own show.
Yeah. Good time.
Hey, I knew you were going to get married because I saw you at the airport.
Yes.
It was just before Christmas, wasn't it?
And do you know that you cut the line?
I had to. I had to cut the line.
Why?
I had shingles at the time.
Oh, really?
It was a medical emergency. I had to get to a comfortable seat very soon.
Wait, is shingles contagious? Because I hugged you.
Yeah. Well, how did you feel?
Awful.
Yeah. That sounds like shingles.
Why didn't you tell me? I was going on the way to getting married.
I didn't want you to think, oh no, I'm going to get shingles on the way to my wedding, which you probably did.
You gave me shingles.
I don't know. It can be contagious if you rub up against the actual shingly bit. Trust me, you did not.
Okay. Shingles or not? Wait. Shingles or not? Wait, you got shingles on that part of your body? Wait, I'm confused.
Oh, no. None of my junk. No, oh. Here. Oh. I got a little shit. That's where you get it. You get it here, yeah. Well, you didn't touch me here, did you?
No, I don't.
I would have remembered.
I don't remember. I don't remember. I don't remember. I was touching a lot of things on that flight.
Before your wedding?
It's the only way to get it in. The only time to get it in. I gotta stop. I'm not even making sense to myself today, so...
You're having a bit of a Freudian penis slip, a bit of a Freudian slip evening. Hey, so where did you get married then?
In India. In
India? Italy. What a lovely choice. Why did you go there?
I don't know how to explain this to you. I'm Indian. No.
No, I don't understand.
I know.
It's because... Which part of India are you from?
New Delhi.
Oh, right.
The capital.
Of India?
So anyway, I got... This is the show that goes nowhere. It doesn't matter.
So
I got married in India. It was a lot of fun.
Did you have an elephant?
No, I came in on a horse.
Oh, nice.
Which is pretty standard. Not that horse that keeps staring at me.
Yeah, okay, knock it off. You're freaking him out. Sorry, man.
It's put in a very interesting position to be directly staring at all the guests.
Yeah, weird that.
So I came in on a prettier horse, no offense, Mr. Creepy Weepy, but I just said Creepy Weepy because, you know why? Because you said twosies. When you were talking about the horse earlier, you said it was going twosies.
Yes.
And I said, if Craig can get away with saying words like twosies, then I can get away with words like Creepy Weepy.
Okay.
Thank you.
No, we have to take a break.
Oh, okay.
Make a promise to your kid, you gotta do it.
Are you a good flyer?
Are you a bad flyer?
Yeah, I'm all right. Hi, everybody, welcome back. Kunal was just telling me about what happened in his wedding.
Yeah, I got married.
Oh, well, that's great. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Well, Kunal Nayyar, everybody.
Yeah, thank you. It was a wonderful time.
Great.
And I, to be honest, I know in a time where, you know, marriage isn't the most sacred thing in the world.
It is in my house, buddy.
Hey, listen, I'm just saying, I love being married.
Great. How long have you been married?
7 months. Yeah. I knew it.
Well, I'm not being cynical about your love, man. I'm not.
No.
Come on, I'm not being a hater on your love. It's cool.
No, I know.
You guys will be great forever and ever.
Thank you.
No, it's fine, man.
I would have invited you if you didn't have shingles.
How did you know? You didn't know I had shingles until I told you right there.
Because when I got back to India, I had shingles all over my body. So I knew you had shingles. Let's stop talking about shingles.
Well, we can't talk about anything. We're out of time.
Oh.
Want to do an awkward pause?
Yeah.
Guest co-wrote and stars in a film. A film! The film is called For a Good Time Call, dot, dot, dot. Yeah. Oh, I'll be seeing this movie. Please welcome Lauren Miller, everybody, Lauren Miller. Look at you. You look sensational.
Oh, why, thank you. You look sensational.
Well, thank you. That's very charitable of you to say. But you really do look very nice. And you had a bath before you came as well.
Backstage, they were bathing, scrubbing me, and yeah, it was crazy.
I'd like to see that. Is this film in any way autobiographical? Were you ever involved in the sex industry?
Well, I was not, but my writing partner, Katie, she ran a phone sex line out of her dorm room freshman year of college. Yeah, it was at Florida State. It was,
I've been there!
You've been there?
I've been in Florida State! I did the powwow there!
So you maybe know her number?
Yeah. Was it, 1-800-FSU- Uh-oh.
Yes!
Oh, wow! Was it really?
Well, it really was.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Gosh, I just made that up. Wow.
You sound experienced with it. I don't know.
No, I never called them. I'm Scottish. We can't talk about sex. It's forbidden.
It's forbidden?
Yeah. Why? Well, we can't talk. I mean, if a Scottish person wants to talk about sex, they just go...
That could be something. I don't know.
What, that?
Oh, I don't know. That grunting noise?
Well, the grunting noise, that's actually actual sex.
Oh.
When the grunting noise... Do you like to talk about sex? When you're having sex?
Sure, in the moment, but maybe not on national television. I don't know.
I don't know, perhaps. So how did you deal with this then? How did she deal with it when she was in the sex? Did you actually talk to people and say, oh, you like that, don't you?
Well, she did, yeah. Well, and she was a virgin at the time, actually. So she actually used Google a lot. And it was like, people were like, let's S&M. And she'd be like, S and M, oh my God. But then she would just go with it. You know, you're supportive. It's about being supportive.
So you just like encourage people?
Yeah, you know, that's what she said. You know, I didn't pick up the phone myself.
So you never even the research for the movie thought, I'll just dial this number and see what they're saying?
Well, my dad is backstage, so no, I did not.
I see. So, did you go to FSU?
I did. I went to film school there.
Oh, nice. I was going to say, what did you study? But if you went to film school, it's becoming evident what you did. Yeah.
It's kind of
That's
obvious.
Good. Is that a good thing to do, study film? Why don't you just come to Hollywood? Because no one else here has got a college degree. Why the hell would you bother?
Oh, I don't know. I think a college degree is valid in a lot of areas, so why not?
Did you find it helpful in the making of the film?
Definitely.
Really?
Oh, my God. I learned so much in school. Yeah, totally.
Gee, I should have gone to school.
I think you're doing quite well.
No, no, au contraire. I've got a robot skeleton, a dancing horse, and very...
I love the dancing horse. You
know, now, I'm doing a little straw poll. The guests are saying when you're sitting there, mm-hmm. the horse kind of puts them off by looking directly at them.
No, I want to go and hug him. I mean...
I wouldn't do that.
No, we don't need to. We don't need to.
No, but I
he looks so soft and nice.
Yeah, he looks like that, but that's like polar bears.
Is he eating people?
Maybe.
Oh, my God.
Have you never seen him with music?
Oh, I have.
Right, well, you know then, because, you know, watch. It's like, that's enough. I've had enough of that. I've had enough of that now. No, polar bears are the same.
Yeah.
They look adorable. Have you ever been to Alaska?
I haven't. My in-laws are actually on their like 7th Alaskan cruise right now.
Really?
Yeah, they left today. 7th. Wow.
7th Alaska?
They can't get enough.
Clearly.
Glaciers, eating on cruises, I don't know.
I've never been on a cruise, but I like the idea of going on a... Well, I've been on a cruise up and down Hollywood Boulevard, but I've never...
How often?
You know, when I was at college.
Yeah.
No, I never went to college. I wish I'd gone to college. No. I wish I'd gone to FSU. It's in Tallahassee, isn't it?
It is Tallahassee.
Yeah, no, I definitely was. I've been there only recently, like that's in the last year.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Did you go to Publix, the grocery store?
Sure. Yeah, I think no. I stayed in this very odd hotel that had a zebra skin rug.
Oh wow.
Yeah, no, it wasn't an actual zebra. Have you ever seen a zebra?
I have. At the zoo. You know, not
do you
in the
do
wild.
You go to do you have you been at the zoo in LA?
I have. It's amazing.
Well, you see, here's my problem. I like the zoo apart. Jeff, what do we hate at the zoo?
Oh, the flamingos.
The flamingos. We hate.
They're so pink.
They're so smelly.
Yeah.
They are foul. Mm-hmm. And you know why?
No, I don't know why.
Jeff, tell her why.
They pee on their legs.
They pee on their legs.
Like.
They pee on their legs when they get warm. They pee on their legs to keep cool. And I keep saying, there's nothing cool about peeing yourself. Well, if you were excessively warm and you were at the zoo, how would you get cool?
Well, I would probably go swim with the polar bears. That would be a good idea.
No, I don't think they have polar bears up there, do they?
I don't know. I can't remember.
Are you always high when you go to the zoo?
Once or twice.
Yeah, no, I like it up there. The monkeys are very fun up there.
Love monkeys.
Yes, but there's another thing about monkeys. Look cute, but be careful.
They'll toss a little something your way.
They'll throw poo your way. They're like little hairy Germans. That's all right to say. If it's accurate, it's all right to say. Yeah. Well, listen, we're out of time. I wish you luck with the movie.
It seems
very entertaining.
Thank you. It is, if I don't say so myself.
Well, you shouldn't. but it does look very entertaining.
Oh, thank you.
Lots of fun.
Yeah. Thank you.
Naked girls and baths and comedy.
I mean, what else are you looking for a Friday night? I don't know.
No, nothing really. That's it. Would you fancy an awkward pause or a mouth organ? Or do you want to go for the big cash prize?
Cash prize.
Oh, really? What time is it, Shauna Stevens?
It's time for the big cash prize.
That's $7.50.
Okay.
$7.50 in nickels. It used to be $50, but we spent a lot on the renovations.
All right.
So $7.50. But I'm going to throw in a shiny red apple and a pair of kangaroo testicles. And all you have to do is answer a question. You ready? All right. All right.
I'm nervous.
Nah, don't be. I've got a feeling you're going to do okay.
Give me an easy one.
Okay. Iceland is in the North Atlantic. Its capital city is Reykjavik. Mm-hmm. About how many islands are there in the Thousand Islands of New York and Ontario? Is it C, 1,500?
Uh-huh. Oh, it is C, 1,500.
C, 1,500 is a great answer. You win the apple. Well, we overran tonight, so we don't have any time for chit-chat. Let me just say, on behalf of Tien and Lisa, Secretariat, Lesbian Row, and these two girls that annoyed me on Twitter, that's it. That's everybody, isn't it?
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
All right, have a safe and happy flight, everybody. Good night, good night.